Hello students, in this video we shall be discussing on the topic chromosomal aberrations. Now what is mean by chromosomal aberrations? So chromosomal aberrations are the changes which are taking place in the genetic material, that means in the chromosomes. The change in genetic material is due to alteration in genetic material through either loss, gain or rearrangement of a particular segment of chromosome or of whole chromosome, and such changes are called as chromosomal aberrations. Chromosomal aberrations are caused by either structural alterations, that means changes in the structure of the chromosome, or numerical alterations, that is changes in the number of chromosomes, and both this results in chromosomal abnormalities. Structural alterations: when part of an individual chromosome is either missing or it is present extra, or it is switched to another chromosome, or if it is turned upside down, then it is called structural alteration. This results in structural chromosomal abnormalities, whereas numerical alterations, where whole chromosomes are either missing or present extra to the normal pair, then it causes numerical chromosomal abnormalities. Structural alterations. So in this video we shall be focusing on structural alterations only. The structural changes in chromosomes are due to break in chromosomes or in its cell division subunit, that is chromatid. So basically the breaks are occurring within the chromosome or chromatid. Each break produces two ends, which may then follow three different paths. Firstly, they may reunite, leading to eventual loss of that chromosomal segment which does not contain the centromere. Now here in the diagram you can see there is a chromosome with segments A, B, C, D, centromere E, F, G, H. Now there are two breaks which are occurring in this chromosome. The first one between segment B and C, and the second one between segment C and D, forming a segment, a broken segment C. Now this segment which is without centromere will eventually lost, and then two ends will join together or they will reunite to form a deficient chromosome. Second, immediate reunion or reconstitution of the same broken ends may occur, leading to reconstitution of the original structure. Now here you can see the same chromosome and the breaks are also occurring at the same position, that is between B and C and C and D. But here immediate reunion takes place and that leads to reconstitution of the original structure of the chromosome. Thirdly, one or both ends of one particular break may join those produced by a different break, causing an exchange or non-reconstitution union. So here the breaks are occurring in two different chromosomes which are non-homologous chromosomes. The first chromosome, the break is occurring between the segment B and C, and in the second chromosome break is occurring between the segment Q and centromere. Here the broken segments of the non-homologous chromosome will be exchanged, and this results into non-reconstitution union. Structural chromosomal alterations are of four major types: deletion, duplication, inversion and translocation. One by one we will see each of them in details. The first one, deletion, which is also called as deficiency. It is a loss of segment of chromosome. After break, the part without centromere is lost. On the other hand, the part which is attached to the centromere acts as deficient chromosome. Further, there are two types of deletion. First is terminal deletion and second is interstitial deletion. Terminal deletion. Here, a single break is occurring in the chromosome at the end, that means towards the terminus. Now, as you can see in the diagram, the break, single break is occurring between segment F and G, and G and H broken segment is formed, which will be lost, and a deficient chromosome will be formed. Interstitial deletion, chromosome breaks and reunite, but the part is lost from in between. Deletions are detected at the time of homologous pairing. If a part of chromosome is missing, then other chromosome also has to omit it in the form of bulging in order to make synapses. So in interstitial deletion, the two breaks are occurring in between the chromosome. And the broken segment, which is without centromere, will be lost. And such type of deletions are detected at the time of synapses, that means pairing of the non-homologous chromosome. So here you can see, here the break is occurring in the segment between the segment E and F and F and G. And the segment F, which is without centromere, it will be lost, forming a deficient chromosome. Now this deletion is detected at the time of synapses, where the normal homologous chromosome pairs with the deficient chromosome. The part where the segment is lost, that part of the normal chromosome bulges out in order to make the perfect pairing. If the missing segment is of physiological importance, then the individual will not survive. So if deletion of that segment of the chromosome is there, which is physiologically very important, then those individuals cannot survive. If dominant A is missing, then the recessive allele small a may express itself. So in the heterozygous condition, where two different alleles of the gene are present, that is capital A and small a, if because of deletion the dominant capital A gene is lost, then in absence of that dominant A, the recessive allele small a will express itself, and this is what is called as pseudo dominance. Now, what are the genetic implications of structural alteration like deletion? So it causes certain diseases or syndromes. Now we will see the example of diseases or the syndromes caused by deletion. The first one, in human, deletion of chromosome 5 results in Cry-Du-Chat syndrome. Cry-Du-Chat is a French word which means cry like a cat. Children cry like cat as there is malformation of larynx. They have small head and are mentally retarded. So in this syndrome, the children cry like cat as the larynx is not properly formed. The heads of those children are small and they are mentally retarded. Partial deletion of 18 chromosome in human results in syndrome with large ears and long fingers. Third one, Prader-Willi syndrome, which is called PWS. This is caused because of the deletion of Q arm of chromosome 15, and this is characterized by mental retardation. A deletion of any portion of a chromosome is usually lethal to diploid organisms, because it causes genetic imbalances. Now, second type of structural alteration is duplication. Here, a segment of chromosome is repeated twice, that is, it is duplicated. Then further, duplication is of various types: tandem duplication, reverse tandem, displaced tandem, transposition, and extra chromosome. Tandem duplication, when duplicating segment is near the centromere, that is, the sequence on chromosome is A, B, C, D, E, F, G. The centromere is present between D and E. Here, the segment EF is repeated immediately after its normal position. So, this is called tandem duplication. Reverse tandem, when the segment is reverse in duplication, for example, segment EF is duplicated, then it will be duplicated as EFFE instead of EFEF. Now, as you can see in the diagram, the first two diagrams shows tandem duplication. Here, the segment EF is duplicated and the duplicated segment is present near the original segment. So, the new sequence will be like EFEF. So this is called as tandem duplication. Whereas, in last two diagrams, you can see the segment, same segment EF is duplicating, but it is duplicated in reverse. That means EF and FE instead of EFEF. So this is called as reverse tandem. Next is displaced tandem. The segment is repeated somewhere away from the original location but on the same arm. Then it is homobrachial displacement, or on the other arm, then it is heterobrachial displacement. So basically, in displaced tandem, the segment which is repeating is not present near its original segment, but it is present away from its original location. And if it is present on the same arm, then it is called homobrachial displacement. And if it is present on the other arm, then it is called as heterobrachial displacement. So here in the diagram, you can see same segment EF is repeating, but it is not present at its original location, but away from it, but on the same arm. Then this is called as homobrachial. Whereas in the other diagram, you can see the EF duplicated EF segment is present away from its original position but on the other arm. So this is called as heterobrachial displacement. Transposition, when the segment is duplicated on non-homologous chromosome, then it is called as transposition. Up till now, we have seen that all the duplicated segments were present on the same chromosome, either in case of tandem duplication, reverse tandem, or even if homo and heterobrachial displacement. But here in transposition, the duplicated segment is present on the other non-homologous chromosome. So here, there are two non-homologous chromosomes are present, and the segment of first chromosome, segment EF, is duplicating on the other chromosome, that is chromosome number 2. So this is called as transposition. The last one, extra chromosomal. Here, the duplication also involves the centromere. If the segment which is duplicating is involving the centromere, then it is called as extra chromosomal. Now we'll see what are the diseases which are caused because of the duplication. So first one is Charette-Marie tooth. This is a disease which is found in human and caused by duplication of 17 chromosome and the P arm of 17 chromosome. It is a degenerative nerve disease that usually appears in adolescence or in early adulthood. The third type is translocation. Transfer of a section of one chromosome to non-homologous chromosome is known as translocation. Translocation is different from transposition. In transposition, we have seen the segment is first duplicated and that duplicated segment is then transferred to the non-homologous chromosome. But here, the section is not duplicated. It is just transfer to any non-homologous chromosome. When there is exchange of segment on two non-homologous chromosomes, it is called as reciprocal translocation. So when there is an exchange of two broken segment of two different non-homologous chromosomes, then such type of translocation is called as reciprocal translocation. It also includes exchange of segment between non-homologous part of a pair of chromosome. The segment is neither lost nor added. It is just exchange. Further, there are three different types of translocation. Simple translocation, shift or intercalary translocation. And the third one, reciprocal translocation, which is also called as interchange. Simple translocation, a single break in the chromosome is taking place and then it is transferred onto the end of other chromosome. As you can see in the diagram, there is a single break occurring in chromosome 1 between segment B and C. Now the segment, broken segment A and B will be transferred to another chromosome, which is a non-homologous chromosome, and it will join to that chromosome. This is called as simple translocation. Second, shift or intercalary translocation. This is a common type of translocation which involves three breaks so that two break section of one chromosome is inserted within the break which is produced on non-homologous chromosome. Here in the diagram you can see two breaks are occurring in the first chromosome between A and B and C and D, forming a broken segment BC. And a single break is occurring in other chromosome between segment R and S. This broken segment B and C will now join in between R and S. So this is what is called as shift or intercalary translocation occurring between two non-homologous chromosome. The third one, reciprocal translocation or interchange. This is frequently observed translocation where single break in two non-homologous chromosomes are produced and there is exchange of the chromosomal segment between these chromosomes. Now you can see there are two non-homologous chromosomes and a single break is occurring on both the chromosomes, forming two broken segments which will be then exchanged. Now segment A and B will join to the second chromosome and segment P and Q will join to the first chromosome. So this is called interchange or reciprocal translocation. Now diseases which are caused because of the translocation. Unlike deletion and duplication, translocation is not so lethal for an individual, but still it is associated with certain diseases or syndrome in human beings. Human diseases caused by translocations are cancer, such as leukemia, and other genetic impact is infertility. Fourth and the last type of structural alteration is inversion. If two breaks occur in one chromosome, sometimes the region between the break rotates by 180 degree before rejoining with the two end fragments. Such an event creates a chromosomal mutation which is called as inversion. So here two breaks are occurring within a same chromosome and it will eventually rejoin, but before rejoining that broken segment will rotate by 180 degree and then join with the other ends of the chromosome. Unlike deletions and duplication, inversions do not change the overall amount of the genetic material. As we have seen that deletion causes loss of genetic material, and in duplication the genetic material is present extra. So inversions are generally viable and show no particular abnormalities at the phenotypic level. But in some cases, one of the chromosome breaks is within a gene of essential function, and then that breakpoint acts as a lethal gene mutation. Which is linked to the inversion. So if the break is occurring within a gene which is of physiological importance, then such inversion is lethal. Otherwise, inversion are not so lethal and the individual with inversion may survive and is without abnormalities at phenotypical level. The location of the centromere relative to the inverted segment determines the genetic behavior of the chromosome. If the centromere is outside the inversion, then inversion is said to be paracentric, whereas inversion spanning the centromere is called as pericentric. So you can see in the first two diagrams, the inversion is taking place in the segment EFG, that and the breaks are taking occurring there between centromere and E, and G and H. That broken segment will reunite, but before reuniting it will rotate by 180 degree, and this type of inversions are called as paracentric. Whereas in the second case you can see ki the inverted part segment also involving centromere. So this type of inversion is called as pericentric inversion. Now the examples of the diseases which are caused because of the inversion. Inversion in some cases have been associated with congenital anomalies, growth retardations, infertility, recurrent pregnancy loss, and cancer. Chromosome 9 inversion is related to Walker-Warburg syndrome, which affects development of muscle, brain, and eyes. And also, this is associated with or related with acute leukemia. Other than these structural alteration or the abnormalities, there are two different abnormal chromosomes which are observed. First one is ring chromosome and the second one is called isochromosome. A ring chromosome which is usually represented as small r is formed when a break occurs on each arm of a chromosome, leaving two sticky ends on the central portion that reunite as a ring. So when two breaks are occurring within a single chromosome, one on each arm of the chromosome, then it produces two sticky ends. And then these two sticky ends join together forming a ring chromosome. Isochromosome, it is an abnormal chromosome that has lost one of its arms and replace it with an exact copy of the other arm. The most probable explanation for formation of an isochromosome is that the centromere has divided transversely rather than longitudinally. So here you can see the centromere is dividing transversely instead of longitudinally. So causing two parts of the chromosome and each is lacking the other arm. So what happens? The arm duplicates itself forming an isochromosome. That means both the arms of this chromosome are same. So this is isochromosome. This is all about the structural alteration which causes the structural chromosomal abnormalities. So in this video, we have studied about the chromosomal aberration which are caused because of the structural alterations. These are of four major types: deletion, duplication, translocation, and inversion. Deletions are of two types: terminal deletion and interstitial deletion. Terminal deletion, where a single break is occurring near the end of the chromosome. Interstitial deletion, where two breaks are occurring within a chromosome, in between a chromosome, and it is detected at the time of synapsis. Duplications are of five types: tandem duplication, reverse tandem, displaced tandem, transposition, and extra chromosome. Tandem duplication, where the duplicated segment is present near its original position. Reverse duplication, it is present near its original position, but before reuniting, it is inverted. Displaced tandem, the duplicated segment is present on the same arm and same chromosome, but away from the from its original position. So this is called as homobrachial, on the same arm. If it is present on the same chromosome but in opposite arm, then it is called as heterobrachial. Transposition, the repeated segment is present on the non-homologous chromosome. Extra chromosomal, the duplicated segment involves centromere. Third type, translocation. Simple translocation, shift or intercalary translocation, and the third, reciprocal translocation or interchange. Simple translocation, single break occurring within a chromosome, but the broken segment transferred to another non-homologous chromosome. Shift or intercalary translocation, two breaks are occurring in one chromosome forming a broken segment. One break is occurring on another non-homologous chromosome. This broken part of one chromosome then reunite, or it is present in between the in between two ends of the broken ends of the non-homologous chromosome. Reciprocal translocation or interchange. So single break is occurring in two non-homologous chromosomes. So exchange taking place, this is called shift or intercalary translocation. The exchange take place between two non-homologous chromosomes, and this is not called interstitial, this is called reciprocal translocation or interchange. The last major type is inversion. Inverted segment involving centromere, then it is pericentric. And if the centromere is out of that inverted segment, then it is called paracentric. And lastly, two abnormal structure of chromosome, ring chromosome and isochromosome. I hope you understand the topic. If you have any doubt, query or any suggestion, please do comment in the comment box.